Hi there. Hello. Isn't it pretty behind me? This is my office today. I just came from a yoga class and I wanted to connect with you before I got back and got officially dressed for the day. So I'm out here in California right now. It's for a business conference with my coach, my mentor. I'm just here for a short trip. And I wanted to come in and help you because I know how being an entrepreneur can just really be so isolating. Just making you feel so lonely and like there's no one else there, especially if you're a solopreneur, you don't really have a team. And you really just have vendors who you're talking to here and there, or maybe a virtual assistant or really small team. It can be really isolating. And what happens to a lot of people is as they're in their work caves, they start to get to this point where they don't see the forest for the trees, they don't see what's going on. And it actually not only is depressing, but it holds them back. So I wanted to talk about that today. If you guys are new to me, I'm Sharon Haver. I'm from FocusOnStyle.com. I'm an online entrepreneur since I started the site in 1999. And I help other smart and savvy entrepreneurs who realize that their expertise is not enough to stand out in a super crowded market anymore. So what happens is when you get into this entrepreneurial cave, you're in the middle of launching a product or creating a new signature talk or just finding more coaching clients or whatever it is, it gets very isolating and you get stuck in listening to all these tactics, all this advice. And what happens is you really miss out on what your true competition is. And your true competition is not necessarily other people of your level. Your real competition is the television. It's reality TV. It's what people are watching. It's those big marketing gurus, the ones that have millions of following that people just tune into. That is what your competition is, because that's going to show up in someone's feed way before, you know, Joe Schmo and Hillary Holiday in your feed or whoever that other entrepreneur is. So by looking at the bigger picture of entertainment and even looking at the directions of what Facebook is doing with Facebook Lives and Facebook Watch and Instagram and IGTV, you'll see that people are connecting on this much more authentic level. At this higher level, that there's a level of consistency of going live, that it's not perfect. Obviously, I just came from a yoga class and I didn't even shower yet today. And I'm sitting here with these beautiful waves behind me. And I said, well, okay, let me make the best of the scenery. But frankly, this light is probably way too harsh on me right now. It's like heavy sun. It feels good on my body, but it probably doesn't look too good on my face on camera. But at least I'm setting up this shot so that you see this prettiness around me and it makes it interesting and engaging. And I'm sharing my reality with you right now. And the same thing goes for not only your videos, but it also goes for your photos. And your photos are your first step in all of this. It's the photos you use in your Instagram feeds and your Facebook feeds and your blog posts. And for me, it started with my book cover. And everything I learned from being on a photo shoot for 15 years as a stylist was very difficult for me to apply to myself, because as an entrepreneur, I am not on this big, full, zhuzhed up photo shoot with all sorts of lights, cameras, and action. Right now, to connect with you, I'm using my phone and I'm resting my arm on a park bench. So you gotta learn how to use what you have when you have it so that you're able to engage. And what goes back to your brand climate is you're gonna start to notice, if you have not already, that this whole idea of becoming an authentic superstar is what's putting you above the masses. And as a matter of fact, I have a challenge called AuthenticSuperstar.com, and you can go over there and I'll show you how to do that, how to stand up and be your best real self and develop your brand and position yourself, because positioning, my dears, is just the new currency right now, to really be a success in what you have. And when you're doing what you have with with what you have and you learn the strategies to do it, you bypass stress, you bypass overwhelm, you bypass having to memorize lines, because now you're just being you and you're sharing you, but you have the know-it-all, the wherewithal to be able to set yourself up. And it's not realistic to be able to have a paparazzi team follow you around to do all of this. I mean, maybe if you're loaded and you like the, you know, the fans around you of people, the sycophants taking your photo and doing everything. But if you're a normal kind of entrepreneur, you need to sort of be what they call in TV news is a one-man band and learn how to do that yourself. So it helps you connect, it helps you be real, it helps you share your experience with the people out there. And being aware of your brand climate and what's happening is the short key way to really be able to get above the masses. Because while everyone else is sitting in their cubicle talking to you with some stage script that they figured out and using all those juicy words that just sound like lots more marketing jargon that, you know, maybe it sounds like you know what you're talking about, but it also sounds kind of like cheesy and inauthentic. And if you're the one who's standing out there and really knows your shizzle because you got all that expertise, but now you know how to position yourself, how to show up to be seen, then you really have the unfair advantage of everyone else who's still using old tactics and going with a white background and reading from a teleprompter and just going, it's really boring. So I invite you to learn how to really accelerate how you show up on camera with my free 5-day challenge, AuthenticSuperstar.com. And really want you to also look around at the industry leaders out there, at the people in your field, and at reality TV and morning talk shows, because that is your real and true competition. Not the person in the other cubicle, not the person you just met at a networking event, but it's the big picture. That's what people are seeing in their feed. And I want you to be seen in the feed of your ideal customer so you can grow, you can scale, and you can attract the kind of life that you want and live the life that others dream about. And quite frankly, I was in my house at Jackson Hole a few days ago. I went back to New York City, and now I'm right here in La Jolla. And I'm telling you right now, I kind of am dreaming about this life. It's pretty darn good to be in the sun right now. So anyway, I'm going to go back and get dressed, guys. I'll see you later. I had a wonderful yoga class. I could hear the seals barking in the background and some sea lions. It was really cool. And I will talk to you soon. Go over to AuthenticSuperstar.com. Bye-bye. Love you guys. Oh, if you like this, share. Share it on your wall. Share it with your friends. Share it with other entrepreneur friends of yours who might need the push to go out there and be their best selves. See you soon. Bye.